Hello everyone, welcome back to our class, chapter 7, Lifelines of National Economy. Now yesterday we were writing the notes. We had started with communication. Now we have to write the notes about personal communication and mass communication. So take out your copies and pens and be ready to write the notes. Put the heading personal communication. I had already given you 3 points about communication. Now put the heading personal communication. First point in personal communication, it is the type of communication which involves, it is the type of communication which involves two persons. It is the type of communication which involves two persons. Full stop and write example. Mobile phone and postal letters. Mobile phone and postal letters. Second point. The Indian postal network is the largest in the world. The Indian postal network is the largest in the world. Third point. The postal network handles personal written communications and parcels. The postal network handles personal written communications and parcels. Fourth point. Mails are categorized, M-A-I-L-S, mails, postal mails, okay. Mails are categorized as first class mails and second class mails. Mails are categorized as first class mails and second class mails. Fifth point. The first class mails include cards and envelopes. The first class mails include cards and envelopes and are airlifted. Sixth point. The second class mails include book packets. The second class mails include book packets, registered newspapers, and periodicals. The second class mails include book packets, registered newspapers and periodicals and are carried by land and water transport Seventh point. Recently, six male channels have been introduced to facilitate quick delivery of males in large towns and cities. Recently, 6 male channels have been introduced to facilitate quick delivery of males in large towns and cities. 8. The six male channels are, put a colon and write in front. The 6 male channels are Rajdhani channel, comma, Metro channel, comma, Green channel, comma, Business channel, comma, Bulk mail channel, and periodical channel. Leave one line, put the next heading, telecom network. First point in this, India has one of the largest telecom networks in Asia. India has one of the largest telecom networks in Asia. Second point, today not only the urban areas but two-thirds of the villages are covered with STD, in bracket you write subscriber trunk dialing, bracket close, and then write facility. Today, not only the urban areas but two-thirds of the villages are covered with STD, that is subscriber trunk dialing facility. That is the facility to call to other states. Third point, to improve telephonic communication, the government has provided 24 hours STD facility, 24 hours STD facility to every village in the country. Fourth point, landline and mobile services have been improved to ensure faster personal communication. Landline and mobile services have been improved to ensure to ensure faster personal communication, faster personal communication. Fifth point, the improvement in telecom services, the improvement in telecom services have been made possible by integrating space technology and communication technology, by integrating space technology and communication technology. Leave one line, put the next heading, mass communication. First point in this, it is the type of communication where the message is transferred to a large number of people at the same time. It is the type of communication where the message is transferred to a large number of people at the same time. Full stop. Second point, it includes radio television, newspaper, magazines, books, internet and films. It includes radio, television, newspaper, magazines, books, internet and films. Third point, it provides entertainment and creates awareness among people about various national programs and policies, about various national programs and policies. I'll read the third point again. It provides entertainment and creates awareness among people about various national programs and policies. Fourth point, All India Radio, in bracket you write Akashwani, All India Radio, bracket close, is the national radio channel and Doordarshan is the national TV channel or television channel, All India Radio, Akashwani, is the national radio channel and Doordarshan is the national TV channel. Fifth point, these national channels broadcast a variety of programs in national, regional and local languages. National, regional and local languages. Sixth point, a large number of newspapers and periodicals, are published annually in India. Seventh point, the largest number of newspapers published in India are in Hindi, followed by English and Urdu. Eighth point, India is the largest producer of feature films in the world. India is the largest producer of feature films in the world. Next point, The Central Board of Film Certification, in bracket you can put CBFC, capital letters, and bracket close, certifies both Indian and foreign films. Full stop. Till here we had learned. So, till mass communication we have done. Now we move on to the next topic, that is international trade. Now, what is trade? We had seen that transport and communication are the lifelines of national economy because they facilitate trade. They help trade to develop. And it is only because of them that trade develops, and when trade develops, the country develops. The next topic is international trade. The trade between different countries. Trade is the exchange of goods and services. The place where it takes place is known as the market. So we are going to learn about trade in the next topic. So take out your book and be ready. International trade. The exchange of goods among people, states and countries is referred to as trade. The market is the place where such exchanges take place. All right, you go to the market, you give the shopkeeper money, he gives you something. So that is trade, that is business going on. Trade between two countries is known as international trade. It may take place through sea, air or land routes. Already transport, we had learned land transport, air transport, water transport. All this helps in international trade. While local trade is carried in cities, towns and villages, state level trade is carried between two or more states. So local trade inside the city, nearby villages, inside the villages, all that is local trade. State trade between two different states, the trade, exchange of goods and services. International trade, exchange of goods and services between two countries. Advancement of international trade of a country is an index of its economic prosperity. How much development has taken place in international trade, how much foreign exchange is being earned by the country by international trade, that decides the index of development of that country. How much prosperous is that country? Is that country economically strong? That is decided by international trade. It is therefore considered the economic barometer of a country. To measure the economic development of the country, you have to take care of the international trade. You have to find out how much international trade is there, how much of foreign exchange is being earned by the country. According to that, you can find out at what position this country stands in terms of economic development, in terms of the strength of its economy. As the resources are space bound, no country can survive without international trade. Resources are space bound. You don't find all the resources everywhere. You find gold somewhere, you find coal somewhere, you find petroleum somewhere else. You find cotton somewhere and resources are space bound, limited to particular places. So all the countries are not self-sufficient in everything. So trade has to take place. They have to exchange things. They have to sell and buy things. And that boosts up the international trade. Export and import are the components of the trade. When trade is there, export and import will take place. Export means you produce something and you sell it to another country that requires that thing. Import means you don't have that thing, you buy it from another country. So selling of your products to other country is known as export. Buying products from other country is known as import. Export and import are the components of trade. If trade is there, export and import will be there. The balance of trade of a country is the difference between its export and import. And balance of trade, how much, or the cost of the material being exported and the cost of the material being imported, the difference is taken out and then you come to get the balance of trade. And balance of trade can be favorable as well as unfavorable. When the value of export exceeds the value of imports, it is called a favorable balance of trade. When you are selling more things, all right, and earning a lot of money, and you are buying less things from other countries, it is favorable balance of trade. But if you are buying things of more value and selling things of less value, then it is known as unfavorable balance of trade. So for a country to be economically strong, the balance of trade should be favorable. That is, export should be more and import should be less. On the contrary, if the value of imports exceeds the value of exports, it is termed as unfavorable balance of trade. This is what I explained just now. India has trade relations with all the major trading blocs and all
geographical regions of the world. Everywhere India's trade is spread out all over the world. Everywhere we have trade relations with all the countries of the world. The commodities exported, what all things are we selling to other countries? Include gems and jewelry, chemicals and related products, agriculture and allied products related to agriculture. All these are being exported by us to other countries. The commodities imported to India, what we are buying from other countries, petroleum, crude and products, gems and jewelry, chemicals and related products, base metals, electronic items, machinery, agriculture and allied products. So many things are here, many things we require from other countries, so we are importing those things. India has emerged as a software giant at the international level and it is earning large foreign exchange through the export of information technology. Earlier also I had told you our IT industry has boosted up a lot. It has provided a lot of employment. It is earning a lot of foreign exchange. So we are emerging, or we have emerged as a software giant in the world. Many countries look towards us for the help in information technology. Tourism as a trade. Tourism in India has grown substantially over the last 3 decades. Tourism, coming of tourists visiting different places, there also so many businesses are supported by tourism. Lot of foreign exchange is earned by the country because of tourism. So it is also an industry. More than 15 million people are directly engaged in the tourism industry. Tourism also promotes national integration, brings the nation together, provides support to local handicrafts and cultural pursuits. Local handicrafts, the people making things at the local level, these things are bought by the foreign tourists who are coming. They admire it, they buy it, and that way these people earn foreign exchange, earn money, and they get an encouragement to produce more of such things. It also helps in the development of international understanding about our culture and heritage. We go from one place to another in the country, we understand about different parts of our country. Tourists coming from other countries, they come here, we understand about them, they understand about our culture and heritage. So all this takes place. Foreign tourists visit India for heritage tourism, ecotourism, adventure tourism, cultural tourism, medical tourism and for business tourism. Alright, to visit the different monuments and all. Other than that, for adventure sports etc. To study about the culture of India, medical tourism, Ayurveda and all, they want to learn about that, they want to experience it, and for business purposes they come here. And all these types of tourism boost up the tourism industry. There is a vast potential for development of tourism in all parts of the country. We are blessed by nature with such scenic beauty and variety of plants and animals and birds. So there is a lot of potential in our country in terms of development of tourism. Efforts are being made to promote different types of tourism for this upcoming industry. So this industry is growing. And there is a great potential for this industry, and the government is making efforts to develop this industry. Different types of tourism are being encouraged and government is trying to develop and strengthen this industry. So we'll stop here. I'll give the notes related to this in the next class, and then we'll also do the question answers at the back of this lesson that are given here. We'll do that also. So be good and take care.